be about. Whatever the case may be. And I actually just got my September box for Book of the Month. Actually my first ever. I just signed up. And I thought, what a better way to start off this channel than by unboxing. Repeat. I already opened unwrapped books. They came in a plastic wrap. And it also brought this really cute little bookmark. It says Book of the Month. And on the back, that's the thing about books. They let you travel without moving your feet. By Jhumpa Lahiri. Sorry if I butchered your name. Which is great. I love bookmarks. I have a bookmark collection, so that is going in my collection. Maybe I'll do a video about that. The book that I chose this month for my actual Book of the Month is The Mermaid and Mrs. Hancock by Imogen Hermes Gowar. And it's really cute. I wasn't expecting it to look like this. So it looks like Book of the Month actually has a special printing done of these books, or at least of the jacket. Cool. compulsively readable, mesmerizing debut in which a prosperously prosperous elderly merchant receives a most unusual creature and meets a most extraordinary gifted woman in a wholly original tale of myth and marvel, magnetism and literary magic. So then the actual summary. One September evening in 1785, just beyond the docks of London, Jonah Hancock hears an urgent knocking on his front door. The captain of one of Jonah's trading vessels is waiting anxiously on the front step, bearing shocking news. On a voyage to the Far East, he sold Jonah's ship for something rare and far more precious. A mermaid. Jonah is stunned. The object the captain presents him with is brown, wizened, and as small as an infant, with vicious teeth and claws, and a torso that ends in the tail of a fish. It is also dead. As gossip spreads through the docks, coffee houses, salons, and brothels, all of London is curious to see the marvel in Jonah's possession, thrust from his ordinary existence. Somber Jonah finds himself moving from the city underbelly to the finest drawing rooms of high society. At an opulent party, he makes the acquaintance of the coquettish Angelica Neal, the most desirable woman he has ever laid eyes on. Of course. And a shrewd courtesan of great accomplishment. This meeting sparks a liaison that steers both their lives in a perilous new course, for priceless things often come at the greatest cost. Imogen Hermes Gawar, Britain's heralded new literary talent, makes her debut with this spellbinding novel of a merchant, a mermaid, and a madame. An unforgettable confection of obsession, wonder, and the deepest desires of the heart, told with body wit, sparkling intrigue, and a hint of magic. So, my love fantasy. This doesn't sound like high fantasy. You know, it sounds like an interesting novel, definitely. Fantastical elements, but it doesn't sound like actual fantasy. But I first book. So I'm actually hoping that this might be that. If it's not, no big deal. Anyway, here's the rest of the synopsis. In the house of Helios, god of the sun and mightiest of the Titans, a daughter is born. But Circe is a strange child. Not nor viciously alluring like her mother. Turning to the world of mortals for companionship, she discovers that she does possess power, the power of witchcraft, which can transform rivals into monsters and menace the gods themselves. Threatened, Zeus banishes her to a deserted island where she hones her cold craft, yes, tames wild beasts, and crosses paths with many of the most famous figures in all of mythology, including the Minotaur, Daedalus and his doomed son Icarus, murderous Medea, and of course, wily Odysseus. But there is danger too, for a woman who stands alone, and Circe unwittingly draws the wrath of both men and gods, ultimately finding herself pitted against one of the most terrifying and vengeful of the Olympians. To protect what she loves most, Circe must summon all her strength and choose, once and for all, whether she belongs with the gods she is born from or the mortals she has come to love. With unforgettably vivid characters, mesmerizing language, and page-turning suspense, Circe is a triumph of storytelling. An intoxicating epic of family rivalry, palace intrigue, love and loss, as well as a celebration of indomitable